We are here with Jan Bertsen, the president of Mental Health Europe. Jan, welcome in Prague again. And can you tell us a bit about the organization Mental Health Europe and what are its aims? And
yeah, okay, thank you. Thank you very much for your invitation here. I feel very honored to be here in Prague for the second time in this building to talk about the work of mental health, about the work of Mental Health Europe. And Mental Europe is an organization in Brussels. It's partly funded by the European Commission. And I think the most important aim of Mental Europe is to provide the best mental health in Europe. Mm-hmm. And our strategy is, I think it's mostly based on human rights. So that's whether today, on the day of human rights, I have to make the decision to be in Brussels now because there is a conference for Mental Europe in Brussels, or to be here in Prague. But I know you a lot of years. I know Pavel from Focus, and I said to Claudia, the director of Mental Europe, no, I have to go to Prague because it's an important day for you in Prague to start your process of, I think, to change the culture and mental health in the Czech Republic. I think you as Focus, there are a lot of good work the last 35 years. And I think it's now time that you can that see all the other people of the Czech Republic what you are doing. And in my opinion, your work in community mental health is I think it's much better for people, for patients, than to stay for years and years in a mental hospital. So that's the reason why I'm here, to support you. And I'm very honored because we see our book, Freedom First, in the Czech translation. And I told both authors that you have translated this book and about the presentation today. And I think it's an important step for you as your, with your, all your colleagues to tell all the people who are still believe that the best mental health would be delivered in a hospital. I think it's more important to stress on that good mental health, you have to do it in the community. With people in their own house, where they can live on their own, with their own goals and their own aims, with their own people, friends next to them. And that's why I'm here.
Yes, it's great, thank you. And I saw your inauguration speech or something like this on internet. And you said that you want to promote peer activities. And that's great because we in the Czech Republic, we have now maybe 100 peers working in different organization, and it's much better. Maybe this would be maybe the next question. How do you think that people can join the community if they are if they have mental health experience with the illness or something like this?
I think it's very important to work with peers in the mental health because I think for patients and all the people who are have psychosocial problems, it's good to have peers in their own neighborhood, I think, to talk about the problems they have. And what I've heard from our peers in the Netherlands, it's really more easier and more important to have a peer as someone who supports you than only a psychiatrist or a nurse. And you're now 100 peers in the Czech Republic?
Something like this.
Okay, okay. I think it's more than in some other countries.
Small amount.
Yeah. But it's still more, I think, than in other countries in Europe.
Uh-huh.
What we try to build up from Mental Health Europe, together with UCOMS, another organization for mental health in Europe, is to build up a peer network in Europe.
Yes,
we are busy great. Now with people from Norway, from the Netherlands, and I think with you, to build up a really strong peer network.
That would be great.
And last time I was here with Martijn Kohler. He is one of our peers of Lister uh-huh. in Utrecht. And I think the next step for you is to be part of the European network of peers.
Mm-hmm.
And so you are very invited to join us in the next period.
I think that this would be really great because we have maybe 100 peers, as I told, but they are in different organizations. There are some organizations which gather small part of peers, maybe 20 of them, but if we can join European network, it will be the best.
Yeah, I think there's a lot to learn from each other. Have you visited our college in Utrecht, ENIC?
No.
Then you have to come to Utrecht next year, I think,
uh-huh.
Because there is we built up a special recovery college, and it's 100% peer run, and it's very successful. And they have about 1,500 students each year, and the effort of training people in living their life, I think it's even more important than your talk with your psychiatrist or your mental health nurse.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a sort of alternative, and perhaps you can build up in Prague your first recovery college.
We have one, but it's run more by professionals. Peers are working there, but
okay,
like they are lecturing, but not. It's not a building. It's only a program.
Okay.
And maybe the last question: How did you personally came to the theme of mental health in your work career? Or
yeah. I don't have my own experience in mm-hmm. the mental health. Of course, I have my periods in my life with some struggles, but mm-hmm. it's not. I'm not a peer. But I think that it's a strange question. When I became a nurse about 30 years ago, I see the strange difference between patients in general hospitals with the right treatment and the right attitude from all the nurses, mm-hmm. instead of the situation in mental health hospitals. So I think I'm more a sort of human rights activist. About 35 years ago, I refused to go to the army when I was uh-huh. 18 years old. And I said, no, I'm not going in the army. I'm a nurse and I do my own thing. So so for me, the most important thing to do, the work in mental health, is to take care of the human rights for people who are sometimes in a very, very difficult situation. So it's more based on my feeling with human rights
mm-hmm.
than on my own experience.